We're going to have a bit to decide who goes first, but it's going to be Remy that goes first.
It's going to be you that goes first.
So, do you want to go first or will it be me?
I'll go first.
Okay.
I'll answer.
All right.
I'll answer.
Yep. First question? All right, first question. Why did you decide to study pharmacy?
Okay, that's actually an easy one. I love studying about medicines. So I love how, like, you can predict the way medicines work in your body or what the medicine is going to do to your body. I think studying that is pretty amazing, which is why I decided to study pharmacy. Alrighty. So Niall, who should study pharmacy?
Who should study pharmacy? You have to be outgoing. I think you have to be an outgoing person. You're going to be working with a lot of different people. And I think you have to like science and chemistry. Why did you choose the University of Sydney?
Okay. Yes, I know there are a few options, but University of Sydney was essentially, it's got the Hogwarts building, guys.
We're the oldest. We're the
exactly,
oldest in Australia.
Yeah.
1899.
It's beautiful. It's close to the city and it just looks beautiful. If I haven't
we're
said
awesome.
It first. Yeah. And the teachers are amazing. The lecturers that I've had, the tutors, they actually are willing to give you one-on-one attention if you need help. Essentially a cohort is amazing as well. So I couldn't have picked a better uni. I'd say that.
Damn right. All right, mate.
Question for you. What are the entry requirements?
What are the entry requirements? So it's all based on ATAR. So if you get an ATAR of 90, you're guaranteed an offer. Other than that, that's about it. Oh, and you have to do maths. You have to get a band 4 in maths.
Mm.
Now, that's a new one starting this year. All right, we've done that one. What career opportunities are there?
So I remember in our second year, I didn't really sort of grasp the fact that there are more career opportunities than a community pharmacy, but we had a hospital night in second year and I realized that you can be a community pharmacist, a hospital pharmacist, a pharmacist who works in the army, a pharmacist who works in the industry, which means you get to work with amazing pharmaceutical companies. You can even work for the TGA.
I'm actually making a little chart that's going to go up on the walls to show all the people the opportunities. Because there's so many, you can't even tell everyone all the ones that are there.
Yeah, you can even be a research pharmacist, a pharmacist who sort of does research, works on new medicines, or you can even come back and teach, which is what I really want to do. Yeah. Are there alternative entries for pharmacy?
Are there alternative entries? Yes, there are. So if you don't get the ATAR that you need to get in, there are other ways to get in. What we recommend is that you come to Sydney University, study for another degree like science, and get a good marks. About a credit average is enough to then be able to transfer into pharmacy. Mm. But you don't have to come to Sydney. We come to Sydney, but if you don't get into Sydney, you can go to another university as well, do well there, and you can still transfer over as well. We have students that come all the time from other universities
I
who transfer in. Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, I started off doing Bachelor of Science, and then I realised pharmacy is actually what I want, so I transferred after my first year.
What are the best aspects of the course?
But I'd have to say learning about the way medicines work is actually the best aspect of this course.
Third year is always very popular with students. It's when students mostly say that's when they feel like a pharmacist.
Yeah. How much time do you spend in placements?
How much time do you spend in placements? So you do, you have a field work day in first year, but it's not until third and fourth year that you go on placements. So in third year, you have to do a 2-week placement. And then in fourth year, you do another 2 placements, one in semester one and one in semester two. And they're about 2 weeks long as well. So I guess in total, you do about six weeks.
6 weeks,
You've done your semester one.
I've done the semester one, but I've got...
You got the semester two coming up?
I've got an industry placement.
Industry placement. Mm. Ooh.
Yes.
That's a long placement.
Yeah, it's a 3-month long placement.
Yeah. But that'll be fun.
It's an amazing opportunity.
What's the company?
NPS.
Ooh.
So NPS is our National Prescribing Service. And I just, it was an amazing opportunity to even be sort of allocated to NPS. But it's industry placement is essentially, there are a lot of companies offering. So GSK, Eli Lilly, and they just sort of bring you on for 3 months and they train you, teach you what they do at their company. So for example, I'll be learning about medication regulations and how that works, the research that goes into it. But yeah, placements can get very interesting. So, next question. Do you have to find your own placements?
Do you have to find your own placements? No, you don't have to find your own placements. We have a system called Sonia, which is what the university uses for all medical students. So if you're a dentist or a doctor or a nurse or a pharmacist, we have a system with all these placements that are organised all throughout Australia. So it could be a community placement in Sydney, or it could be a hospital placement in Katherine or Broken Hill or anything. But no, we find the sites for you. You're allowed to put preferences in. So you can say, look, I don't want to have to move all the way to Western Australia for 2 weeks. And we take your preferences into account, but we find the placements for you. Do you know anyone who lives on campus?
Yes, I do. A few of my friends do live on campus, and that's because they are originally from, say, Canberra or even Brisbane. So, yeah, so I do know a few people who live on campus, and it's actually very easy. There are societies out there to help you, especially if you're in first year, you've just started pharmacy or like a degree, and you don't know how the whole thing works. Are there any exchange opportunities?
Exchange. I think this one means international exchange. So there are thousands of exchange opportunities. We have students, I think, in past years that have gone to different countries in Europe. So Denmark, the UK, France, Germany. Students are always going to America, East and West Coast. We have New Zealand, Singapore. So I think it's just a matter of, do you want to do it? And then you can almost pick where you want to go, because Sydney University is so connected with all the lots of other universities. There's so many different places you can go if you want to do it.
How do you get accredited to practice pharmacy?
How do you get accredited? It's a little bit of a process. So you have to do an accredited degree, which of course Sydney is. We have two of them, the Bachelor of Pharmacy and the Master of Pharmacy degrees. When you finish that, you have to do your intern year, which is supervised practice. You have to do about 1,000 hours of practice and undertake an intern training program. And then when you've done those two things, you can sit your board exams, and there's an oral and a written exam. And when you pass that, you're registered and you can work anywhere in Australia that you want.
And good thing is that we actually offer that intern training program here at University of Sydney. So you don't have to travel anywhere. You just have to come to uni and then see your old friends, see your old, you know, academics, and then, yeah. Alrighty, last question for you. Are there any scholarships available?
There are scholarships available. So it does depend on who you are, what your background is. So there are scholarships for students from low socioeconomic backgrounds. There are scholarships for students that are coming from rural areas. And we have scholarships for very high-achieving students as well, because we want the best people here. We like to say we're elite without being elitist, and we want the best people here no matter where they come from. So if you do well, there's money for you.